FM.
We're in the midst of royalty, right here in the city of Nawabs and Kebabs. The Lime Brigade has arrived in the glorious city of Lucknow. Hello and welcome to Lessons in Marketing Excellence Season 7. I'm Khuri. IIM Lucknow, one of India's premier B-school institutes, has carved a niche for itself in marketing, finance and consulting. Famous or maybe infamous for being one of the most rigorous programs on offer, it has added another feather to its rather illustrious hat by becoming mentor to the newly established IIMs of Rohtak and Kashipur. Let's take a look at IIML's performance online. Starting off well in the inaugural season, the institute finished the competition fourth, slipped to the seventh place in season two, and thereafter never managed to regain their flair. They finished last on the leaderboard in season three, 12th in season four, 11th in season five, and 12th again last year. Will this year fare better for their fortunes? Sell everything quicker. With a catchy tagline like that, they enter the booming e-commerce market on the right foot. In layman's terms, Quikr connects buyers and sellers on their platform through classified listings. While 70% of Quikr's business currently comes from mobile phones, they are looking at spreading their wings to other verticals like cars, real estates, jobs and services. Quikr today facilitates about 2 lakh real estate transactions every month, resulting in a gross transaction value of 20,000 crore rupees. The key competitors for the brand in the market are pure play online real estate players like 99acres, Magic Bricks, Housing and Common Floor, making the competition real tight for the brand. The challenge for the team is to devise a strategy to get consumers to start buying, renting and selling homes online. Bring about a change in perception in the minds of their TG to see the brand as a strong real estate classifieds player. So here we're at IIM Lucknow, and now it's time to meet the team. So quickly tell me your team name, make your introductions.
Our team name is Dexter.
We are team Tigara, Kaam Bigada, and the missing team member is Sukanya Arora. She's gone to Delhi.
Thank you very much. And you guys?
Yeah, hi, we are team Titanium.
Girlies.
Hi, we are team Nagina from IIM Lucknow.
And you guys, your team name?
Our team name is Smoking Tree.
Alright, and you have a team member missing as well.
We have a team member missing. She's on student exchange program.
Alright, thank you. So here you have it. These are the 5 teams. They're going to battle it out. As you all know, the case study for them is from Quikr. So let's see what the team challenge is. We'll be giving every team 3 products to sell. You will get a stipulated time of 15 minutes. The team that comes back after 15 minutes with the maximum money wins the challenge. So now it's up to you. You can auction your product, you sell it for the most amount of money. You can describe your product to whoever you're selling it to. Ultimately, you have to make the most money. 15 minutes, 3 props. So first, of course, we're promoting Green India and of course Clean India. So what we're giving you is one plant of Genda Phool. You have to sell that. Secondly, as a refreshment, there is a packet of ready-made tea which you will make. All you have to do is just add hot water to it. Sell a cup of tea to someone, and kaun chai nahi peeta yaar? Everyone wants chai, right? And there is a full pineapple that you will sell to someone who you think is in dire need of a refreshment. Okay, so these are the 3 products. Sell it however you want. Describe it nicely to your buyer. Then your buyer can examine it and everything. Alright, so you all have 15 minutes on the clock. Maximum money that you can make. Make it the quickest that you can do. Ready?
Yes.
Your props are right over there, okay? Your time starts in 3, 2, 1, go! Are mazo!
बहुत बढ़िया पाइनएप्पल है गुप्ता जी से बहुत अच्छा पाइनएप्पल है
थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक यू सो मच
ये
चैलेंज चल रहा
है
वेट में दिक्कत है रूम नंबर बताओ रूम नंबर बताओ
1360
500
अरे तो बहुत
थैंक यू
और 200 रुपए
क्या
200 रुपए और है
क्यों
नहीं नहीं सब 1700
बहुत अच्छा प्लान है
काटते हैं आपके घर पे बहुत अच्छा रहेगा, घर पे बहुत ही सुंदर लगेगा। और वो गेंदे का फूल ऐसे हम हर जगह फंक्शन पे लगाते हैं कुछ भी अच्छा करने से पहले, तो आपको कभी फूलों की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ेगी, बस फूल निकालने की देर है।
Not gonna find any other pineapple within the campus for the next few days. So this is the last pineapple remaining in the market.
Oh, no, how much do you give?
Oh, more dog.
No.
Really don't know if you paid your friends or whatever it was, but you all put in a lot of effort. This task was fun, wasn't it? So you all of course get your money back. Yeah, of course you do. Now look at her. Oh, thank you. Look at the relief. She actually went like this. So well, give yourselves a big round of applause. So none of the teams today will get to decide their position for tomorrow, and yeah, let's see. We'll pick a draw, we'll pick chits, and that's how we'll come up with the numbers tomorrow. All I can say is, I want the same enthusiasm tomorrow in front of the jury. I want that same confidence, because every single team was confident that they've won. So bring that confidence to the table tomorrow. Good luck. I'll see you again, okay? All right. Thank you. And with that, it's time to take a short break. On the other side, we'll bring you all the action from the campus round at IIM Lucknow. You're watching Lion Season 7. Welcome back. You're watching Lessons in Marketing Excellence Season 7, and we're at the beautiful campus of IIM Lucknow, the regal city of Nawabs and Kebabs. It's time now to meet the jury panel that is going to decide the fate of the teams. First up, we have Anand Rangaswamy from CNBC TV 18. Next, we have Satyabhushan Dash, Professor Marketing, IIM Lucknow. Vineet Sehgal, Chief Marketing Officer from Quikr. And Vipul Mathur, Category Head for Mass and Mid Fabric Wash from Hindustan Unilever. It's time now for the executive pitch. And the first scene up is Teen Tigada Kaam Bigada.
Physical, tangible presence in order to put their trust in that person.
After all five teams finished the pitch, and based on jury deliberation and audience poll, the two teams to make it to the next round are Team Teen Tigada Kaam Bigada and Team Nagina. May I request Teen Tigada Kaam Bigada to please come and take your positions at the podium. And we're ready for your team presentation. Team Teen Tigada Kaam Bigada, you have 3 minutes on the clock to make your presentation, at the end of which we will sound the buzzer. It will be followed by a Q&A with the jury. Are you ready?
Yes.
Alright, so wish you all the very best. Put in your best foot forward. Your 3 minutes starts now.
Hi, so today we're presenting the case for Quikr, wherein we need to explore how Quikr can move into the online real estate space. I'm sorry. So first, we start by looking at some of the gaps in the market right now. When we look at some of the issues that exist, so firstly, the market is dominated by individual brokers and developers who basically reduce our control as Quikr on the supply side of the market. Second, we look at the existence of black money in the market and also other colored components which are there, which basically exist because of a lack of documentation of the transactions that take place in the offline space. Then there are also unsatisfactory after-sale services that are happening in the market right now. So and also there is no retail assistance for the buyers. So just next, we look at some of the opportunities that exist. So based on the issues, the opportunities that exist for us are that there is no one-stop real estate shop there for the buyers as well as for the brokers and developers, which we plan to offer. So based on some primary and secondary research, we got some really crucial insights for our model. So first was that there is an inferior research material. So basically, all the information that the buyers are looking for is not available at one place. They have to go to different places to get that information. And also we found out that the real estate market in India is growing at a CAGR of 15.2%, and that will be driven mainly by online real estate.
Also, a couple of other insights was that if a person is committing a huge amount of money in terms of property or buying a home, so they need certain physical tangible presence in order to put their trust in that person. So provision of physical outlets and customer executives would meet that need, and also preparing of a proper verification and credit rating system would help avoid exploitation at the hands of the unorganized market.
As we discussed, we have three stages of our plan of execution. In the first stage, in the first 6 months, we plan to start advertising Quaker Homes through various TV and social media websites, which will help us create a sense of association among customers. At the same time, it will also help us relate to the channel part, becoming channel partners of the developers. And at the same time, we also plan to start helping out customers in an end-to-end assistance model. In the second 6 months, we plan to launch Quaker Homes physical outlets and penetrate more into the market through the personal assistance model. And we also plan to execute our hyper-localization model of brokers.
And in the final 1 year, so this was primarily in the tier 1 cities, but in the final stage, the final 1 year, we plan to expand this model into the tier 2 and tier 3 cities. And apart from that, what we plan to do is we plan to conduct a lot of educational seminars, educational events in order to help the people get to know, avoid exploitation at the hands of the unorganized market. And finally, we plan to...
Your time's done. No, I saw your segmentation and I see you're focusing on SEC A and B. Do you have any clue how small that market is? Can you, if you focus on SEC A and B, can you even hope to achieve Quaker's ambitions?
So basically, while we're concentrating on the SEC A and B categories, so that is only for the initial phase if you're looking at. So right now, in the initial phases, what the primary purpose is to get a foothold in the tier 1 cities, create a awareness among the people, actually get them to associate Quaker with the real estate segment. So only once we got a foothold in this segment, once we've done this, then we plan to move on to further new segments. So initially, in the initial 6 months, when you plan to target these two classifications, at that time our purpose isn't actually to increase our market share as much as possible, rather than to create a connect in the minds of the consumers, get them to know about the brand, create a brand connect.
If I'm a consumer, you're getting the same brokers online, Quaker is getting them online as per your recommendation, why would I trust them? Just because Quaker has got it, what is it I'm doing differently that will build that trust, which anyway I don't trust those guys? And secondly, how is getting information, how am I differentiated or how am I disrupting the market, which others can't do either? So why can't an existing player like a 99 Acres or Housing or any player for that matter not get the same information and therefore how am I differentiated?
There are two aspects to cover here. So we recommended setting up of a credit rating and verification system. So what we are doing before getting brokers on board is we're looking at their, we're trying to get a look at their past track record, the kind of services provided by them, other people, they're dealing with, are their clients happy with them, and that would help us create a sort of a database which people can look at before coming on board and selecting a broker.
Do you think brokers will provide that information?
So that is some background check which we'll have to look at alternate sources to conduct.
And why would a broker want to be a direct competition to them? So why would he say, listen, you know, I'm going to provide him all my professional past history, which there is no record of. It's a totally unorganized market. He half the time deals in black money, but maybe 90% of the time. He's got unscrupulous practices. And he would certainly want to become transparent and co-opt with the potential competition who will disrupt his own market and say, listen, I'm happy to come online.
Okay, so first I had another point to answer your previous
question.
So another aspect is, so if you're looking at an unorganized market, if you approach a broker, so there is no accountability. Probably he's working in a temporary office, the next time you go to his office he won't be there. But if you're associating brokers with our brand Quaker, so there is some sort of accountability which falls on us. So if something goes wrong, we are providing guarantee for that because the brokers are on our payroll. So that again would help people trust the brokers who otherwise won't trust the people working in the unorganized market. The majority of brokers are trying to get on board a small players who got very limited market outreach right now. So they're dealing basically with people either they know through their own contacts, so basically some sort of referrals. So by getting them on board, basically what a kind of structure we're trying to build is through the process of hyperlocalization, we're dividing areas between these brokers. So they get a wider market outreach. And the kind of commission we're taking from them is currently, in the initial phase, is very less. So most of the commission with the earning from the transactions will be passed on to them. And basically, our aim through getting these brokers on board is to get maximum market outreach. So it's a mutual benefit. They get a greater market through us, a larger number of people.
That's right. You're going to have a structured product that will deal with all kinds of consumer requirements. You'll have a rating system for brokers. You'll have relationships with multiple types of brokers. You'll have a physical outlets of Quaker. You'll have TV communication and online communication, YouTube. Tell me some of the things that you will choose not to do, because I'm assuming you have finite funds. Yeah. Hmm. So tell me some of the things that you will not do.
So something which we can drop is the advertisement. So right now we plan to advertise only in the initial 6 months. So after that is done, it's only in the next phase that we are starting thinking of setting up the physical outlets and starting with the credibility system development. So once we're done with the initial 6 months, we'll scale down our advertisements a lot, because after that, our primary aim is to create a personal connect with the customers. Thank you.
Thank you. Team Teen Tigara Kaam Bigara. Thank you very much. With that, it's time for a short break. On the other side, the final team will make its presentation and we'll find out who the champions are from IIM Lucknow. You're watching Line 7. Stay tuned. Welcome back. You're watching Lessons in Marketing Excellence Season 7 and it's a packed campus over here at IIM Lucknow. It's time for the next team to make its presentation and here they come. Welcome team. All set, wish you all the best. Your time starts now.
Behavioral insights were gathered through surveys, FGDs and in-depth interviews of 150 respondents across 6 cities comprising of IIML alums, friends, relatives and brokers. On the basis of attitude towards online shopping, the target buyer has been segmented into the tech-savvy, the shopping avoider, time-start buyer, necessity buyer. The target seller wants to schedule viewings as per convenience, is wary of the ad posting process and wants to avoid brokerage. Insights have been clubbed under 3 headings, the individual, the broker and quicker. Individual, problems identified. Insufficient or incorrect specifications in listings, continued queries on resolved listings, reluctance to share details due to privacy concerns, lack of quality listings under PGs and hostels, desired features, a human touch, information regarding proximity to amenities, clarity over paperwork and security checks.
The broker. 95% of all listings are updated by brokers. Main incentives to shift online are increased lead generation, save on infrastructure costs, desired features, build trust among customers, special assistance in return for premium fee. Quicker. Problems identified are insufficient awareness about the real estate category, preference for focused real estate portals.
Recommendations. We propose the launch of Quicker Dunya, which will serve as an all-in-one portal for real estate needs. Objectives will be met via a 3-pronged action plan, establishing Quicker as a strong real estate player, getting the consumer online, building a strong broker community. Key features are a 360-degree marketing campaign, print and OOH ads like, are you still looking at classifieds? We sell houses too. Quicker. Social media posts about DIY ideas and pointers for real estate investment.
Quicker tags. Help brokers sell better through past viewing history, priority-based listings, and one-touch appointment scheduler.
Quicker Campus Connect. Campus ambassadors to collate hostel and PG needs for the batch by city, budget, office location requirements, and provide a platform for sellers to reach this market.
Quicker Seal the Deal. Features like follow-up calls and prominent placement of resolve ad button. This will reduce the clicks needed for ad removal from existing 4 to 1.
Quicker Community. Revamp blog with features like Ask Our Experts, hashtag home buying story, hashtag quirky quicker houses contest. Har ghar kuch kehta hai section about vastu and DIY interior ideas.
Quicker homework. Predictive analysis to offer targeted listings and cross-sell furniture and services. SEO and AdWords to increase organic and inorganic searches. For example, a search and buy a house in Bangalore did not result in any quicker links on the first page.
Search quicker. Quicker road runners to map the amenities in a given locality. Value-add information on the lines of nearest ATM 3 kilometers away.
Quicker trust. Promote broker engagement through exclusive branding on high traffic pages, custom designed ads and listings, higher rankings in search by broker listings, broker of the month on the blog. These will be supplemented by Quicker Talks, Pals, PA, Docs, Group By and the 90-Day Challenge. The impact will be measured using the following metrics. Total visitors and page views, unique visitors, conversion rate, number of likes, comments, shares and retweets on social media posts, discussions started on blog posts as well as participation in contests. All the above recommendations will be implemented in a 3-phase manner spread over the next 2 years. Thank you.
So how do you think that the recommendations will be feasible for this company to implement, and how you think also what confidence you can tell that it will be really beneficial for consumers?
So in our research, when we were talking to a lot of respondents across categories, across age, across geographies, we identified that different kind of people had different problems. For example, someone who is time starved, someone who is a top professional doesn't have time. So the weekends go exactly on the property visits. Can we do something about it? So we recommended Quicker PA for that, a personal assistant who helps you design your ads and takes you to the property visits, ensures that everything is going right and expedites the process. So different segments identify different problems, and we had different features to map that problems that different segments have are solved.
Do you think it's a good idea to extend to just a Quikr Homes, and why not call it something else? Mm-hmm. And secondly, what are the elements of the Quikr's brand equity that you think will extend to this category, and which are the elements which will actually be at risk, will cause risk to the mother brand?
We decided to go for Quikr Duniya, not Quikr Homes, because first of all, we wanted Quikr Duniya to be a one-stop shop. So it's not only about finding or renting or buying a home. Through our features, we are ensuring that you're finding your neighbors, you are actually seeing the amenities, you can map the locality. So we didn't want Quikr verticalization, vertical only to be about homes, but all other things that make a home a Duniya per se. That's why we go forward with the Quikr Duniya recommendation.
Also, one of the reasons why we went ahead with Quikr Duniya. We believe that the reason why Quikr is, why it's a good idea for Quikr to move into a Quikr Homes or a Quikr Duniya is because the consumer is not aware of Quikr as a real player in the real estate market.
With brokers being made such an integral part of this, what is your revenue model? Why will you ever make money?
So our features are divided across three. It's not just that we're focusing on brokers only. For example, when we are trying to get customers online, so we suggest that, for example, features like group buy or features like PA. For example, when 12 or 13 people indicate that they want to buy a particular new developer's building, they indicate that, and Quikr then goes to the developer and says that, hey, I have 15, 13 people who want to buy blocks. Will you give a discount? So it's not that we're just focusing on brokers. Yes, it's an integral part, but one of the three-prong approach that we are using. So all three, we have features for all three. Yes.
Right, thanks. All right.
Thank you.
That was Steve Nagina. And now it's time for them to please kindly step outside while the jury deliberates. So we have the results. It's been a very tough competition. I'm sure you guys will agree with me. It was very neck to neck. It was very tough. But at the end, there has to be only one winner. So who thinks Teen Tigara Kaam Bigara has made it? Put your hand up if anyone thinks they're the winner. Okay, who thinks Nagina has made it? And the audience is correct. The team to win is Nagina. Congratulations. Well done. Let me tell you quickly what they are going to win. They win cash prize of 50,000 rupees. Yes, that's right. From Hindustan Unilever. And the fast track route to the pre-placement interview round at HUL. Also, they win very stylish fossil watches and lime hampers. So, congratulations for all of that. And now, may I request Nipul to please hand them the check of 50,000 rupees. This episode of Lime. Join us next week as the teams from SP Gen battle it out for housing.com. Until then, from the entire team, many thanks for watching.
Focus. Argue. Innovate. Enable.